Having access to a seedbox is a very convenient way of downloading and uploading files from and to the internet. But how to access the files on the seedbox with a Windows computer? The easy answer is to use the file transfer protocol, also known as FTP. But there's a major caveat. Windows does not support encrypted file transfers via FTP. In this video, I will present you a free-of-charge solution to integrate your seedbox as an ordinary Windows drive into the Windows Explorer. Let's start after the intro. Let's first take a look on the file transfer protocol and how it works in Windows. You can take your GigaRapid hostname and the FTP port and enter it into the address bar of the Windows Explorer. You are then requested to enter your credentials. All this information can be found on your GigaRapid dashboard. This is easy, but if you apply this procedure, you will not have encryption activated for your file transfer. Therefore, I will guide you to enable FTPS and at the same time access your files right off in the Windows Explorer. To achieve this, we need to download three pieces of software. We start with rclone. I downloaded the 64-bit version for Windows. Next is the non-sucking service manager, which can create a Windows service. Check the video description for the download links. The last piece of software is WinFSP, which enables FTPS support for rclone. After the download, I extract rclone to my documents folder. From the NSSM archive, I grab a single .exe file from the 64-bit folder and copy it into the rclone folder. WinFSP is an installer and can be installed with the default options in place. Now we can start configuring rclone. I open up a Windows Terminal window and navigate to the rclone folder by using the cd command. In this folder, I execute the rclone.exe file with a config option. Make sure to use autocomplete with your tabulator key to get the dot and backslash before rclone. A short config wizard starts in which we select the option to create a new remote. For the name, I choose GigaRapid FTPS. The next step asks you for the type of connection. I scroll up until FTP appears and enter the number 13 in the storage selection. In the next step, I copy the FTP hostname from my GigaRapid dashboard to the command line window. rclone now asks for the username, which we can also find on the GigaRapid dashboard. The FTP port is not 21 as you may think. You have to check your dashboard on GigaRapid to get the port right. rclone asks if you already have a password, which you can confirm by using the epsilon key. The password is not displayed while you are entering it on the command line. Now the important part. For the TLS encryption, we are using explicit TLS, so for implicit TLS we choose false and for explicit TLS we choose true. The advanced config is not necessary, so we choose no. In the last step, we confirm the correctness of the just entered information and leave the wizard with Q for quit. This Windows Terminal window was running as administrator, so I can go and mount the FTP drive, but will not see it as I'm logged on as useful vid user and not as admin. To fix this, I open up a new terminal running as the current user and repeat the mount command. Thank you. After some waiting time, I can see a new drive on my PC with the contents of my Giga Rapid storage. This was too fast, then let's examine the arclone mount command. I call the arclone exe file, followed by the mount command. This tells arclone what to do. The mount command is followed by the name of the storage. In our configuration, we used the name Giga Rapid FTPS. So we enter the same name here, followed by a colon. The string after the colon is the path of the FTP storage on Giga Rapid. The first folder you see, if you use FTP at Giga Rapid, is called storage. After the FTP path, we have to enter the Windows drive letter, which will be used in the Windows Explorer. I can now browse through my Giga Rapid files in the Windows Explorer. After I started the video, I can see some errors popping up in the background. This can be fixed by setting the cache mode to full. You will find this command in the video description. If you take a look in your app data folder, you will find an arclone config file with the information we just added. This is the place where the mount command gets its credentials from. This will be important in a moment. Executing the mount command manually is not so much fun. The solution is to create a Windows service and to make sure that this command is executed right at the Windows start. This is the reason why we downloaded the application Non-Sucking Service Manager at the beginning of this video. You can just call nssmexe in the command line followed by the install command and the name of the service which will be created. A graphical interface pops up in which we enter the path of arclone and the mount arguments. As the service is not started as the user use full vid, we have to use an additional argument. The full path of a config file is required to make this work. If you hold the shift key while performing a right click on the file, you will get the option copy as path. I copied the whole command in the notepad to show you the entire command. Take a look at the video description if this was too fast. You can now install the service. If you take a look in the service overview, you will see that the service is not yet started. You can do this manually now. As long as the service is set on automatic, it will be started at every Windows start. After you start it manually, you have to wait some seconds before the drive shows up in the Windows Explorer. To show you how well this method works, I copy some large files to give you an impression how fast this transfer can work. That's it. Thanks for watching. If you like this video and are interested in a Giga Rapid Seedbox, please consider using the affiliate link in the video description.